Besides, since you're not worried about this guy Copper, how about when you get through with him? What are your plans after that?
Well, you're right. I'm not even worried about this big bum. Copper will only be a warm-up until I get to that big ugly bear, Sonny Liston.
I used to train in South East London them days, and I used to run like 4 o'clock in the morning, and I used to see all these old girls like mums and grandmas who used to be doing like early morning cleaning like in the big factory. They used to say to me, "You stop that loud mouth, give him a good wallop." I called him at Wembley Stadium in front of 40,000 people. You know, he came in the ring with a blue silk dressing gown with a crown on. You could feel the atmosphere, couldn't you? I mean, Henry, Henry. It was so thick you could cut it with a knife.
So here we go. The fight of the year, played from the right-hand corner against Copper of Britain.
Well, see, 63, when I first fought, he was a novice at inside fighting. I mean, I roughed him up inside. I had his nose bleeding in the first round, and he kept looking at the ref appealing, "Look, ref, break, you know." I came from a working class family. No good fighter comes from a middle class family. You've got to be wanting to get out of the environment you're in. That's what motivates a fighter. My father was a boy soldier in the First World War. He was in the Royal Horse Artillery, pulling them old cannons, and he did a bit of boxing in the army. So he taught us the fundamentals of boxing, got down on his knees and taught us that way, you know, and listened to stories about Granddad. I mean, he must have been out of a character. And he was into 20-round bare-knuckle fighting. And Granddad was fighting a man, and if he had a wife and the wife sort of butted in, my gran used to go up and start a fight, and she never sort of pulled air, it was full-blooded punches. As a working class lad like I was, I never expected to get any honours. Good Lord, I mean, I boxed because I like boxing, all right. Then suddenly I got a knighthood. I've been to Buckingham Palace 10, 15 different occasions. You know, I'm a royalist. I believe in a royal family. I don't want a president. I don't want some trumped up guy who's like gonna con the country and that, who wanna be a president. The Queen hasn't put a foot wrong. She's done everything right. All right, one or two of the family have just let her down a bit, but I still want a king and a queen more than a president. He was doing a bit of showboating. He was dropping his hands. So I showed him one left, I showed him another left, and then when he couldn't get back any further, pop, I hit him with the left hook. And when I used to hit him with the left hook, the eyes used to shoot up the top of their head, and both his eyes were at the top of his head.
The bell has sounded, and he's up at about three, Clay.
Well, he learned one thing. He learned that basically he had a pretty good chin, if he didn't know that before. He knew that he could take a good shot and then recover from it.
And I think Claire's got a torn glove. And I think you're right. And now we come to round five. Oh, and now Cooper's left eye is really in a shocking state.
The alley fight, I had the worst cuts in my career. Basically, the bone had come through the flesh. A plastic surgeon stitched it. He put 40 stitches on the inside and 40 stitches on the outside. Ali always played me a great tribute because he always said, "Copper hit me so hard, he didn't only shake me, he shook my relations in Africa." Now, that's a blooming good line. I mean, you've got to give him credit there.